Hey Devils!
Welcome to the second episode of the Devil Nation News, brought to you by the Video Production Club here at Coginchaug Regional High School. I'm Matt.
And I'm Alec. This month, we'll take a look at who our new principal is.
We'll give you an update on sports.
And we'll show you a few entertaining clips. Devil Nation News starts now. Another year, another principal. For the third year in a row, Coginchaug is under the guidance of a new principal.
Many rumors have surrounded much of the early goings to the school year, but let's get to know the man with the plan a little better.
Mr. Falcone took over as principal of Coginchaug on July 1st of this year.
There's a lot of good candies out there. I would have to go with Dove chocolate, just because inside, while you're laughing, Dove chocolate, inside the wrapper there's like inspirational messages, and it's like a fortune cookie for me, so when I open it, I get like inspired to do different things. I have three daughters, a 10-year-old, a 7-year-old, and a 2-year-old. My 10-year-old's name is Madeline, my 7-year-old name is Jillian, and my 2-year-old is Olivia. I don't really have a favorite animal. I used to like cats, and my cat seems to be pretty evil, so I don't like cats as much anymore. I would say a dog, because if I got a dog, maybe I could not have a cat anymore. On the first day of school, I saw how X Block unfolded, and I was concerned because I just saw everyone, you know, kind of hanging out, but I came to realize no one really had a lot of work at that point to be touching base with their friends on or their teachers on. So I think X Block is a very valuable time for us here. But we'll be talking about that, but I don't see X Block leaving us. We're gonna start to discuss the schedule going forward, the schedule for next year, what we want it to look like, if we wanna keep the block, if we wanna not keep the block, if we want to have classes meet every day instead of every other day. Those are some conversations and discussions we're going to be having starting on Thursday. I have teachers working on homecoming. I have a committee. We're going to work with Mr. Barberi in creating hopefully a homecoming week. I think it should be a full week that leads to our football game with all different sporting events throughout the week, trying to get as many students as we can there to support our teams and have different spirit games and wars going on in our school against freshman, sophomore, junior, and senior classes, have a pep rally. I've thrown out the idea of a bonfire to different grades, and hopefully something like that could occur.
Do you wear Crocs?
No, I do not wear Crocs. I know that there are some on the staff that might wear Crocs every single day of the year, even when it's snowing, from what I've heard. And I'm just going to leave it at that.
You're clearing up our concerns.
You're welcome.
Here at Coginchaug, we like to think our sports teams are the best, because they are.
1 month into the fall sports season, it is easy to see why we think this is.
Let's check in with Jess and Jamie for an update on our teams.
Boys and girls cross-country teams are off to impressive starts, with senior Christian Alberico leading the way for the boys with an undefeated season thus far. The team is in line to move up many spots in the Shoreline rankings this year. The girls continue to impress with an undefeated record in class meets this year, with each varsity member posting at least a top 25 mark in each meet. The girls are primed for a great run at the Shoreline title.
Let's go, Big Blue!
The football team has been unquestionably impressive in the early goings of the season, staying undefeated with wins over Old Saybrook, Westbrook, Hyde, HK, and Lewis Mills, and only allowing a total of 28 points over that same span. The boys look to make the state tournament for the second straight year.
Devils at three!
One!
Two!
Three! Devils!
With an undefeated season at home thus far, the girls' soccer team has been impressive in the early goings of the season. With captains Janelle Berry, Sean Whitaker, and Taylor Marino leading the way, and with a little help from Larissa Cade's strong foot, the girls are looking to continue their success by kicking their way into the postseason. Coming off a three-game winning streak, the boys suffered a loss at the feet of Old Saybrook. After a slow start, the boys seem to have been gaining confidence with every touch of the ball while knocking off powerhouses HK and Hale Wright. Under the leadership of captains Garrett D'Amato and Danny Gavrilovich, the boys will be looking to turn things back around and make a run towards qualifying for the Shoreline and State tournaments. With the majority of last year's varsity team gone, this year's varsity girls volleyball team has seen its ups and downs under the direction of a new coaching staff. With an early record of 6-5, the team looks to improve their record in the upcoming month. Come support the girls' volleyball team in their upcoming home matches.
To be or not to be? That is the question.
No, that is not the question.
Fine. Come with me as we ask Coginchaug the question of the month.
I'm Al Wozniak, Dell Nation News, and we're going to go see what everybody's favorite part of the Durham Fair was. Let's go. So Callie, what was your favorite part of the Durham Fair? Okay. What was your favorite part of the Durham Fair?
Working with Mr. D at the banana bin.
Do it!
What's your favorite part of the fair, Miss Walsh? So Aaron, what was your favorite part of the Durham Fair?
I have to say my favorite part of the Durham Fair was performing with Show Choir.
That sounds really rehearsed.
It was.
Practicing singing. What was your favorite part of the Durham Fair?
I liked it when the cars drove around and hit each other.
Nice. What was your favorite part of the Durham Fair?
I have to say Mrs. School on Friday.
So Chloe, what was your favorite part of the Durham Fair?
The food.
Everybody loves the food. Mm-hmm. I'm here with Jenny and Zach to see what their favorite part of the Durham Fair was.
The food.
The food.
Everybody loves the food.
So Justin, what was your favorite part of the Durham Fair?
Food.
Okay, we've gotten food a lot, so I think it's unanimous. Food wins it.
After months of high school, the freshmen should be well on their way to being at ease with Coginchaug. We interviewed a few freshmen. Let's check in and see what the first month has been like.
So far at Coginchaug, it's been good, and it's fun. There's a lot more freedom, and having like the AB day schedule, I like it a lot better than having like the AB.
I think it's a good place. Has a lot more freedom than strong. You have X block, which allows you to walk around the halls. Longer periods mean you have to worry about less classes.
I like Coginchaug because it has more freedom than strong, and all the teachers are really nice, and the classes are really like good, and I get to take some of my favorite classes.
My first month at Coginchaug was a lot better than I expected, because all of the upperclassmen were a lot nicer than I thought.
The scariest thing on the first day of school for me was being scared of getting lost.
No, I didn't get lost, but I was scared.
The biggest part of coming to Coginchaug was seeing all the upperclassmen here, because they were all new people and I didn't know how they act to freshmen.
I thought the scariest part was having all the grades in like one school and having so many upperclassmen and underclassmen in the same vicinity.
The upperclassmen have been nice and they're kind.
How have the upperclassmen treated you so far?
Great! Lovely!
Well, what are you doing?
I'm weighing myself.
Why weighing yourself, kid?
I'm pretty sure I gained 5 pounds this weekend at the fair.
Well, the 95th annual Durham Fair is come and gone. Students, faculty, and staff all took part in its experiences. Here's a quick video montage of all the fair activities this year. Roll the footage.
Baby, your song, you made me wanna roll my windows down.
said, fire it up, let's go get this thing stuck. Baby, your song, you make me wanna roll my windows down and cruise down a back road, blowing stop signs through the middle, every little farm town with you in this brand new Chevy with a lift kit. Would look a hell of a lot better with you up in it. So baby, your song, you make me wanna. And strummed a couple chords and sang from the heart. Girl, you sure got the beat in my chest bumping. Hell, I can't get you out of my head. Baby, you a song, you make me wanna roll my windows down and cruise down a back road, blowing stop signs through the middle, every little farm town with you. Well, baby, you a song, you make me wanna.
Thanks for watching. And also, we are in need of new members. Anyone interested in joining or running their own segment on Devil Nation News, please see Mr. Doniker. And also, follow us on Twitter.
Tune in next month for more Devil Nation News.
Don't be salty, Coginchaug.
Selling popular corn. I could have been a mess, but I never went wrong. Cause I'm putting down my story in a popular song.
I said I'm putting down my story in a popular song.
My title, I never was a model. I never was a starter. But you were always popular. You were singing all the songs I don't know. Now you're in the front row. Cause my song is popular.
In the toilets, now it's you that cleans. You're trying to make me feel bad with the things you do. It ain't so funny when the joke's on you.
Ooh, the joke's on you. Got everyone laughing,
got everyone clapping, asking how come you look so cool. Cause that's the only thing that I learned at school. I said that's the only thing that I learned at school.
My title, I never was a model. I never was a starter. But you were always popular. You were singing all the songs I don't know. Now you're in the front row. Cause my song is popular.
True to you, that's all you ever need to know. Catch up, cause you got a long way to go.
You only have